Summer roost monitoring is a crucial component of the Wisconsin Bat Monitoring Program. Roost monitoring volunteers provide the program with valuable information that increases our understanding of Wisconsin bats. In addition to lacking information about basic biology, phenology, and population levels in Wisconsin, bats in North America are threatened by the disease white nose syndrome. White nose syndrome is a fungal disease that fatally affects bats during hibernation. The disease has mortality rates of up to 95% at affected sites and has the possibility to cause regional extinction of common bat species. The Roost Monitoring Project helps the bat program gather baseline data before white nose occurs in the state and increases our understanding of bat populations throughout the state. The survey is conducted by counting the bats as they emerge from the roost. The species you will see during a roost count are either little brown bats or big brown bats, both of which are susceptible to white nose syndrome. Female little brown and big brown bats congregate in structures such as buildings and bat houses in spring and summer to give birth and rear their young. Bats give birth to pups from June 1st through July 1st. This is known as the pre-volant period. At 3 to 4 weeks after birth, the pups are ready to forage and fly. This stage, when the young begin to fly, is known as the post-volant period. Ideally, surveys are conducted during both the pre-volant and post-volant period. However, all levels of commitment are welcome. Colonies of bats can often be found in buildings such as old houses, churches, barns, and of course in bat houses. If you know of a roost on private property, be sure to seek landowner permission before accessing the property. After finding a suitable roost, determine where bats are exiting before the first survey. To find the primary exits, look for discolored areas in and around chimneys, eaves, and soffits. Guano will likely be found below these exits. If all exits cannot be viewed from a single location, it may be necessary to enlist the help of family and friends to ensure an accurate count. Surveys should be conducted when starting temperatures are above 60 degrees. Wind speed should be less than 12 miles per hour, and it should not be raining. To conduct a survey, arrive 30 minutes before sunset. Situate yourself so that you can see the bats silhouetted against the night sky as they exit. Count the bats as they exit the roost. It may be helpful to tally the number of bats exiting on a piece of paper or to use a clicker counter. Some may re-enter the roost, especially when there are pups inside. Be sure to note re-entries as they may affect your final count. If an overwhelming number of bats exit at once, estimate, counting by tens as they emerge. Do not shine a light into the roost, as this may disturb the bats and is not an accurate way of counting. If no bats have exited for a period of 5 minutes, the survey is complete. Remember to fill out the data sheet completely. For more information on how to become a roost monitoring volunteer, visit the Wisconsin Bat Monitoring Program website or call 608-266-2576.